मैम रिकॉर्डिंग की कर रहा था मैम, पर आपने कर दी।
अरे कोड रिकॉर्डिंग स्टार्ट हो गया। हाँ करे, थैंक यू। हाँ सो आइसोमेरिज्म इन एडल्स। सो आइसोमेरिज्म यू नो टू टाइप्स आर देयर, वन इज कॉल्ड स्ट्रक्चरल आइसोमेरिज्म, सेकंड इज कॉल्ड स्टीरियोइसोमेरिज्म। स्ट्रक्चरल मीन्स टू डायमेंशनल एंड स्टीरियो मीन्स थ्री डायमेंशनल। सो इन ईथर्स स्कोप ऑफ ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ आइसोमेरिज्म, दैट इज स्ट्रक्चरल आइसोमेरिज्म। इन स्ट्रक्चरल आइसोमेरिज्म थ्री different type of isomerism exhibited by ethers, which are they? Write the first one, chain isomerism. Write the first one, chain isomerism. Chain isomerism. Then chain isomerism, is the screen is visible to all?
Yes, screen ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Okay, what is written on the screen? Govind, read
preparation
out.
Preparation of ethanol.
Ethanol. Okay. Ha, correct. Now we will continue. Chain isomerism. What is chain isomerism? Molecules having same molecular formula but having difference in number of carbon atoms in the parent chain. Okay, number of carbon atoms in the parent chain. So I will give one example. You have to write the name of the ether. Name of the ether you have to write. First you write 1-methoxybutane. 1-methoxybutane. Okay, 1-methoxybutane. And it is isomerized with the next compound. Write the name of that also. One methoxy, 2-methyl, 1-methoxy, 2-methyl propane. 1-methoxy, 2-methyl propane. Done. So look at the molecular formula. What will be the molecular formula of the compounds? C5H12O. C5H12O. Look at both the structures. Both the cases formula is same, C5H12O. But in the first case, number of carbon atom in the parent chain is 4. Second case, number of carbon atom in the parent chain is 3. So this is all about a chain isomerism. Second, you can write functional isomerism. Functional isomerism. So write one sentence. Ethers showing functional isomerism with alcohols. Ethers showing functional isomerism with alcohol. Simple example we will take. Methoxy methane. I'll tell you the formula. C2H6O and structure is CH3OCH3. It shows functional isomerism with ethanol. Ethanol formula is CH3CH2OH. Although they have same molecular formula, C2H6O. First case, the functional group is ethereal oxygen atom is there. Second case, the functional group is hydroxy group of alcohol. So this is second isomerism, third isomerism. Anyone can say which will be third isomerism exhibited by ether coming under structural isomerism? Anyone can say?
पोजीशन
पोजीशन विल नॉट कम बिकॉज यू नो हियर वी हैव डायरेक्टली टेकन वन सब्स्टिट्यूएंट एंड वन पेरेंट चेंज सो पोजीशन इज नॉट अ मैटर ऑफ कंसर्न एंड विच इज लेफ्ट
हेलो जी
which is left I am asking name of isomerism it is metamerism do you know what is metamerism molecule having different number of carbon atom on either side of functional group very simple example we will write first case you can write the example ethoxyethane what will be the formula ethoxyethane formula is C2H5O C2H5 means CH3CH2O CH2CH3 it shows metamerism with methoxypropane CH3O CH2CH2CH3 methoxypropane Both the cases, molecular formula is same. That is C4H10O. You can count the number of carbon, then number of hydrogen atom and oxygen atom. So it is C4H10O. But number of carbon atoms on either side of ethereal oxygen atom in the first case 2 each, and the second case one side it is 1. Carbon atom, the other side it is 3. So this is all about isomers. Now let us think about method of preparation of ethers.
Air gets into the container. Ethers is by the dehydration of primary alcohols in the presence of an acid catalyst. Typically, sulfuric acid at 140 degrees Celsius. Notice that two molecules of a primary alcohol form a dialkyl ether and water. Drowsiness and damage. Ethanol meant for industrial ethanol are used 140 degrees Celsius.
So, is the screen is visible to all? This is the first method of preparation of alcohol. Sorry, ether from alcohol. So, we can write the name of method of preparation: dehydration of alcohols. Dehydration of alcohols. Okay. So. Primary alcohol on heating with concentrated sulfuric acid. Primary alcohol, that is important. Okay, then convert this degree Celsius into Kelvin. How much it is? 413 Kelvin. 413. Primary alcohol when heated with excess primary alcohol, that is important. So in bracket you can mention excess primary alcohol on heating with the concentrated sulfuric acid and the temperature is 413 Kelvin we get ether. This is general representation of dehydration of primary alcohol. Okay, write this equation first. So it is better to write temperature in Kelvin instead of 140 degrees Celsius. You can write 413 Kelvin. Written? Is it written all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Reaction you can write. Let us continue.
Notice that two molecules of a primary alcohol form a dialkyl ether and water. For example, two molecules of ethanol undergo dehydration in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid at 140 degrees Celsius. To form ethoxyethane.
Now write this specific example. Ethanol. In bracket, you can write excess. excess ethanol, then concentrated sulfuric acid 413 Kelvin. We get ethoxyethane. This is one example. One specific example, okay? Equation is sufficient, more than sufficient. If you have completed, someone will tell me, guide me, so that we can't waste our time. We can save our time.
Yes, ma'am.
This reaction does not work with secondary and tertiary alcohols.
So this is important. We are talking of only primary alcohol. In the case of secondary and tertiary alcohol, this will not work. So it can't be used for the preparation of secondary and tertiary. Okay. Because many reasons are there. Before that, let us focus on this reaction again. Here, 2 points we were highlighted. Which are the 2 points? First one is primary alcohol will be in excess quantity. Second is temperature maintained to be 413 Kelvin. These 2 points are very important. Why is it so? That is important. If alcohol is not in excess quantity and the temperature is just more than 413 Kelvin, it means if it is 414 Kelvin, so we will not get any ether. Instead of ether, we will get an alkene. Or if we are using ethanol, under the condition, that means alcohol heated with the concentrated sulfuric acid above 413 Kelvin, we get an alkene. Again, the reaction is coming under the same category, dehydration, but the product is different. Why the product is different? Because we are not following two conditions. Okay, that is important. First condition is alcohol was not in excess quantity and temperature is not 413 Kelvin. So that means in this reaction, temperature and quantity of alcohol taken in the medium is important. Okay, so these two are very important. And second, this is the particular reaction where the reactant follow SN2 mechanism. First case, primary alcohol follow SN2 mechanism. In the case of secondary and tertiary alcohol, if it function, so it must follow up an SN1 mechanism. SN1 means what? Substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. Okay. So one more question is there related to the same topic. Let us continue.
Note
first.
That secondary and tertiary alcohols produce alkenes via elimination.
This is the reason. Look this. Secondary and tertiary alcohol can't used for the reaction. The reason is instead of ether, we get an alkene. So here you have to just write the statement. More than sufficient. Secondary and tertiary alcohol cannot used for this purpose because if secondary and tertiary alcohol is using, they must follow an SN1 mechanism and resulting an alkene. Okay? Resulting an alkene. Or if you want any specific reaction, you can write the same, which is already given in the screen. Okay? So, am I continue? Okay, you are writing the equation. Instead of R, you can write any alkyl group, CH3, C2H5, C3H7, both the cases. Okay.
Ma'am, completed.
completed. Okay, Ayush completed the work. Good. Someone from other side, girl side.
Completed.
Okay, Harshit completed. Any others? Till three students, I'll wait.
Completed, ma'am.
Completed. Good, good. So let us continue.
Ethers can be prepared by the dehydration of primary alcohols by an SN2.
Write the next topic. Okay. Before that, I will ask one question, because every case we will discuss possible conceptual question also. Write the question. Dehydration of alcohol cannot be employed. Dehydration of alcohol cannot be employed to prepare unsymmetrical ethers. To prepare unsymmetrical ethers. Why? Give reason. Okay, that means give reason. Understood the question? When we look at dehydration of primary alcohol, we can see that we get a symmetrical ether. Okay, and this method cannot be employed for unsymmetrical ethers. What will be the reason? Anyone? Simple logical answer. Even though it is a conceptual question, but logically you can think. Why it is not employed in the case where we need an unsymmetrical ether? Okay, I will give one question. If we want unsymmetrical ethers, we have to use two different alcohol, correct? Suppose we will use methanol and ethanol, then only we will get an unsymmetrical ether. If we use methanol and ethanol, we will get a mixture of ethers. Mixture, imagine, mixture. Suppose we are taking methanol and ethanol, I'll tell you possible ethers. One possible ether is dimethoxy ether. Second is a diethoxy ether. The other one is a methoxy ethane. Second one is ethoxy methane. So many cases. So we get a mixture of ethers instead of a single product. When you write one particular possibility, then only you can understand. So you can try with one example. Write one example. Ethanol plus propanol. Ethanol plus propanol. And think about possible compounds formed as the product in this reaction. Okay. Leave space for the answer. You think it. And try to complete the answer. Okay. Write all possible product obtained from ethanol and propanol. Okay. Leave it. Leave the space. And let us continue the same topic. Mechanism of the reaction. Mechanism. This is very important. Mechanism of the reaction, and we know that this is through SN2 mechanism. So there are three steps in this particular reaction. First step, you can see that here. The name of the process is protonation. This process is called the protonation. You can see that it is simple. H+ attack on this oxygen atom by making use of lone pair of electron. That's why here this oxygen has a positive charge. Therefore, the product is called the oxonimide. Second step, this oxonimide reacts with one more molecule of alcohol, same compound. See that? That's why it is one of the condition is excess alcohol. So one more molecule of ethanol react with oxonium ion. We get two products. One is a stable product water. Another one is a dialkyl oxonimide. Dialkyl. Both the side alkyl groups are there and oxygen carry a positive charge. That's why the name of the compound is dialkyl oxonimide. This is the second step. Write these two steps and remember that both are irreversible reactions. It is a single-headed arrow in first case. Second case also a single-headed arrow. Moreover, second step is a slow step. Try to write name of the product in both the steps. One case oxonium ion, second case dialkyl oxonium ion. Completed?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Alima, you will tell me after completion of two equations. Alima, are you there? Alima?
Yes, ma'am. I'm completed.
Okay. So I'll continue.
Mechanism, which means that the reaction involves an attack by a nucleophile and is a bimolecular slow step. In the first step, the ethanol forms an oxonium ion or a protonated alcohol. In the second step, another alcohol molecule attacks the oxonium ion to form a dialkyl oxonium ion. This is the slow step of the mechanism. In the third step, the dialkyl oxonium ion loses a proton to form the ether. Notice that the hydrogen ion consumed in the first step.
Write the third step. After that, you can listen to the explanation. Oxonium ion removes one proton. So this step we can say that deprotonation. First step is protonation. Second, last step is deprotonation. Perhaps through this reaction we can prove that acids function as a catalyst. Look at that. Reaction start with the H plus as a reactant. It is consuming somehow. But at the last step it is regained. Look. So that means it is an acid catalyzed dehydration reaction. Okay. Third step is deprotonation, removal of proton. First step, protonation. These are the three steps of mechanism, SN2 mechanism. After completion of the step, you can write mechanism of conversion of ethanol to ether. Conversion of ethanol to ether. Mechanism of.
Ma'am, why is it not clear?
Voice is not clear. Okay. Now is it clear?
No, no, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay. Maybe some. Okay, okay. Have you written step?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now tell me whether feasible or not. Okay. Otherwise, you will switch to the next step. Okay. Now you start reading. So that way, maybe promise there. So you can write one thing, write this question. That alcohol leads to propoxypropane. After that, I complete, close this, stop sharing, okay? Because we can't continue with this. Okay, so let us try with another tool, see whether it is working or not. Now, am I audible to you, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let us see. Now, the screen is visible. Bachcho, screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us try with this, okay? Maybe we have problem with audio. Okay, so let us change it. No problem. There is a will, there is a way. Okay, now screen is visible. Bachcho?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. We will go along with this tool, okay? So, we have discussed this method of preparation, dehydration of alcohol, correct? So, this one also we have completed. Now let us think about next method. This is the last method. Two methods are there, only two methods. Write this method, write the name. Williamson synthesis. Williamson synthesis. For the preparation of ether. This is important. First of all, it is a name reaction. Second way, it is a method of preparation of ether. Okay, that's why this is important. And first of all, what is Williamson synthesis? So I will give the not in one single sentence. Okay, first you understand. An alkyl halide is treated with alkyl halide. Look at this, alkyl halide is treated with sodium salt of alcohol. See that? We get ether. This is the reaction known under the name Williamson synthesis. Okay, this is already given here, written here. When an alkyl halide is treated with sodium alkoxide, we get ether. This reaction is called the Williamson synthesis. Write the reaction in one sentence, description in one sentence. Write one common equation, that means general equation, then one specific example. These are these three points are more than sufficient. Okay. When an alkyl halide is treated with a sodium salt of alcohol, we get an ether. This reaction is called the Williamson synthesis. Okay, so this is the first point you have to think about. And let us think about the next point related to this. There is one limitation for this method. Which method? Williamson synthesis. What is the limitation? This is the limitation. Secondary and tertiary ethers can also be prepared by this method. But in this case, we have to preferably take what? Alkyl halide of reactant with the sodium salt of alcohol. See that. So I will explain again so that it will be clear to you. The halide used in Williamson synthesis should be preferably primary haloalkyl. Okay. So I will show you the next previous one. See, look at this. This is halo alkane. That means alkyl halate. Suppose we want to prepare secondary or tertiary ether, we needs to. That means we should take alkyl primary alkyl halate. Okay, primary alkyl halate we should take, and we should take sodium salt of alcohol. Otherwise, what will happen? Okay, otherwise what will happen? If suppose we will take tertiary alkyl halate, it is given in the next slide. Look at this. This is called tertiary alkyl halate. Okay, this is tertiary alkyl halate. This halogen is attached to tertiary carbon, and the second condition is sodium salt of alcohol. Simple, sodium salt of methanol, and the reaction is called Williamson synthesis, but the product is not the expected one. Look at the product. This is the product obtained. Instead of ether, we will get an alkene. Okay, this is the limitation of Williamson synthesis. Okay, so I will tell you. You can write this point, note down the point. The halate, the alkyl halate used in this reaction should preferably a primary alkyl halate. Preferably a primary alkyl halate. Because if we use secondary or tertiary alkyl halide, secondary or tertiary alkyl halate, elimination reaction takes place in presence of sodium salt of alcohol. Sodium salt of alcohol resulting an alkene as the major product. An alkene as the major product. Okay, so this is important. This is considered as the limitation.
एक
और बार बता दू.
Yes,
the listen. The alkyl halide used in this preferably be a primary alkyl halide, because if we use a secondary or tertiary alkyl halide, it undergoes elimination reaction in presence of sodium salt of alcohol. Forms an alkene as the major product. So this is considered as the limitation of Williamson synthesis, and this is all about limitation. Now we will come to the next point. Physical property of ethers. It is mentioned in the single slide. Ethers are in which state? Liquid state. Very few are in gaseous state. Colorless, insoluble in water. They have low boiling point compared to alcohol. So the reason is very clear. Alcohol, hydrogen bonding is there, and in ether, no hydrogen bonding is there. That's why it is insoluble in water. okay, no need to mention all these physical, okay. Chemical property, only two chemical properties are there, only two. This is the first one, reaction with the hydrogen iodide. Reaction with the hydrogen iodide. Write the general equation. Ethers react with hydrogen iodide at low temperature, we get alkyl halide and alcohol. Alkyl halide and alcohol. So write a specific example here. Ethoxyethane when react with HI gives iodoethane and ethanol. So this is the only reaction related to aliphatic ethers. Okay, these are the two reactions. Only two equations are there. No need of any explanation. Am I moved to the next slide? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this one you can write. This is another example. Another example of reaction with the HI. Here we are using a tertiary ether. Tertiary ether, only equation you have to write. Only equation. Tertiary ether react with the hydrogen iodide. We get a primary alcohol and tertiary haloalkyl. General you can write here, okay? Here you can write primary alcohol. Here you can write tertiary haloalkyl. Only equation. Completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Last, second reaction, that means last reaction, electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophilic substitution reaction. And here you need to write only one single point. Alkoxy group is ortho-para-directing. Alkoxy group is ortho-para-directing. So, During electrophilic substitution, we will get two product. We will get two product. One is ortho-substituted product.
Wow.
Another one is para-substituted product. Ortho-substituted product and second is para-substituted product. Written OR. OR means alkoxy group is ortho-para-directing. So during electrophilic substitution, we get two product. One is ortho-substituted and second is para-substituted. The reason is, look at the structure. In all the resonating structure, especially second, third, fourth, the transfer of lone pair of electron takes place only at two positions. One is ortho. Look at this. Second is para. And the other one is ortho. So, because of that, it is considered as ortho-para directing. One example you can write. Halogenation. For example, halogenation. One more point you have to write. Write down the name of this reactant. It has a common name called anisole. Very important. A-N-I-S-O-L. Anisole. Okay, bromination, reaction is bromination. Two products are there. One is para-bromo anisole. Second is ortho-bromo anisole. One example is sufficient, but if you want, you can write one more example. Write halogenation, then write the equation. That's more than sufficient. And don't forget to write name of the reactant. So again, you can see that out of these two, which is major and which is minor? Para is major and ortho is minor because of the same reason, due to steric hindrance. Repulsive force exists between heavier group. Okay. So if you want, you can take one more reaction. Nitration. Nitration. And here, instead of sulfuric acid, you need to write nitric acid, HNO3. HNO3. Okay. Then the products are correct. This is HNO3. Then we get para product and ortho product. Para is major and ortho is minor. This is HNO3. Okay. So these two reactions are more than sufficient. This is all about ethers. Okay. So the second chapter is over now. So I am coming back. So this is all about our second chapter. Last topic we have covered.